Watching Jabril Peppers play football is kind of like watching a Wes Anderson movie. It's very unlike anything else, but my god, is it working. The way Greg Williams has used him is incredibly interesting. In Peppers' rookie season, it seemed like he was constantly out of position. Now, it seems like he could play any position he wants. Take a look at this play, for example. First things first, it's just going to be a great play design. Cleveland knows that Case Keenum can sometimes struggle to get the ball out quickly, and so they're going to take advantage of that by blitzing here. Because it's a blitz, it means that Cleveland is going to be in man coverage. As you see, this is the route concept Denver's running, and it's really not a great route concept to beat man, as most of the routes are designed to be deep passes down the field. Since it's a blitz, Keenum won't have time to throw the ball that far. This is where Peppers comes in. Since Cleveland's rushing 6, and Denver only has 5 offensive linemen, this means that someone is going to go unblocked, and in this case, it's Peppers. However, Peppers knows that if he runs straight to Keenum, Keenum can break to the outside and potentially have enough time to make a deep throw. So instead, Peppers is going to make a small move just to the outside. It's nothing major, but that one step forces Keenum inside the pocket, and it leads to a sack. That play shows what Peppers can do when rushing the passer. Now let's get into what he can do playing a more traditional safety role. On this play, Cleveland's going to try to sell as though they're blitzing. However, this is going to be a cover one robber. This is the route concept Denver's running, and as you see, they should have a route wide open towards the end zone. Keenum actually does a pretty good job here. He reads the defense quickly and gets the ball out. Now Cleveland was able to get some pressure, and so Keenum wasn't able to make an exactly perfect throw. He probably would have liked to get that a little bit more on the line, a little bit less of a lob, but it was still a pretty good decision by Keenum. However, despite that, Peppers is so fast, he's able to sprint all the way down there and pick the ball off. You can't really blame Keenum too much for this one. After all, Peppers is in charge of essentially guarding the entire end zone, yet he's still able to run over all the way to the sideline and make a play. I almost feel bad for Keenum. It kind of reminds me of one of those episodes of Curb Your Enthusiasm, where Larry David doesn't do anything wrong, but still everything goes wrong for him. It could have been a better throw, but Keenum really didn't do too much wrong there. It was just a great player making a great play. On this play, Cleveland's running a pretty standard cover two man. As you see, this is the blocking concept for Denver. And if you look over, the closest unblocked man is Peppers, who's all the way in the end zone. From this angle, it honestly looks as though Cleveland should just be hoping to not give up a touchdown on this play. Also, you're going to want to take a look at Trevon Coley here. He does a great job of shedding his block and getting into play. He slows Lindsey down enough, and when Peppers comes in to finish the play, he doesn't just stop Lindsey of making a big gain or a touchdown. He stops Lindsey of getting the first down. And given the fact that his assignment was to guard the end zone, it really just goes to show how big of a range he has. Let's talk about this play. It's a big play in the game, as it's 4th down and 10 with only 40 seconds left. If the Broncos get this first down, they probably win, and if they don't get this first down, then the Browns win. So it's a huge play in the game. As you see, Cleveland's front 7 is all very close to one spot, and they could be doing a few things here. Their linebackers could be dropping back into coverage, or they could be playing man coverage. However, they're actually going to do something a little different. Instead of having all 4 men on the line rush the passer, they're going to have a man who is lined up as a defensive end guard a receiver. And as far as their linebackers go, they're going to have all 3 rush the passer as well. This is a very uncommon play from this formation. However, it's going to work out very well. Once again, Denver is not going to be able to pick up everybody, and the guy to look at is Jabril Peppers. Despite Peppers running straight into Keenum, he did it so quickly that Keenum never had a chance to even throw a ball up for a jump ball. He came away with a big sack and sealed the victory for the Browns.
We like sports and we don't care who knows. From shooting hoops to the Super Bowl. We like sports and we don't care who knows.
Football, tennis, hockey, golf.
The game is starting, everyone is here. I got my snacks, my friends, and a beer.